Hey everyone, I hope all of you guys are doing good and staying safe. In the previous video, we took a look at how NACLs work, which is the first layer of security in Pure VPC. Let's take a look at the second layer of security in Pure VPC, which is called as a security group. So all of your traffic on a subnet level has to cross a NACL, which is stateless in nature, to then go to your security group, which is stateful in nature. So I like to always call a security group as a stateful firewall. So the security group works in such a way that by default, all of your traffic is denied and only the traffic that you allow is allowed. And all you need to do is only specify that traffic in your inbound because it's stateful in nature, that it maintains a state table, that automatically that traffic will be allowed in outbound. So you don't need to add your rules on the inbound as well as the outbound. You just need to add it on the inbound. So let's take a look at what security groups do, where they are associated. Security groups are associated to any resource that you place within your VPC, such as a virtual machine or a load balancer on the application load balancer or a database. So in that way, you have a second layer of security that is attached to the network interface of all of your devices that you place within your network. A NACL is on the subnet tier, whereas a security group is on the network interface level. So let's take a look at creating a security group that would allow SSH access to any virtual machine that I launch within my custom network. So I am on the left side navigation bar on the security group tier over here. And you can see, let's create a security group. Let's call the security group as my web server SG. And the description is to allow access on port 80 and 22. For SSH and HTTP, because this is a web server. I would like to place this security group into my custom VPC that I've created. And you can see by default, the security group does not have any inbound rules, but it does have an outbound rule that allows all traffic. Let's create an inbound rule because by default, security groups work in such a way that all traffic is denied. Let's create a rule to allow traffic for port 80 and 22. To the outside world and probably port 22 to just only my IP address so that you see the difference. So I'm going to add a new rule. I'm going to say HTTP traffic can come from anywhere. And I'm going to say, since this is a web server, HTTP traffic can come from anywhere. I probably have an application running on port 80. People can access it. Let's add a new rule for SSH, which is port 22, that you go ahead and access the operating system of your virtual machine. So this access can only come from my IP. Another best practice for you guys over here, throughout the entire course, you're going to learn some best practices. Another best practice over here is that don't give SSH access to everywhere, like not 0.0.0.0/0. SSH should only go to a specific set of IP addresses. So they automatically have a script to determine my public IP address. You can always compare this with my IP when you put it on the browser. You'll be able to see that this is my public IP address. So the description I'm going to give is only I can SSH. If you have more people who would like to SSH into the operating system, you can add more IP addresses over here, or we will see a new concept called as prefix list in the next video. I'll let you know about it. Okay. But for right now, in this video, you can see that for our security group that we have created, HTTP can be accessed from anywhere, whereas SSH can only be accessed from my IP address. And this is the best practice. Let's go down and let's go ahead and click on create security group. So now if I associate this security group to my virtual machine, my NACLs are open. A person can go through my subnet to access my virtual machine on port 80 for the application that's running. And a person can access the operating system as long as his IP address has been added to the security group. So you have two levels of security controls within your VPC. One is your NACL sitting on the subnet level. They have to cross your NACL to go into your network interface. And the security group is associated to the network interface as a stateful firewall. So I hope you understood the differences between NACLs and security groups. So in the next video, I will take a look at some of the additional concepts of VPC. So have a great day, have fun. I'll see you all in the next video.